Dispatch, we just pulled over the car and Rodrigo's now going to check if who the heck is inside right now. Over.
No.
We have a little problem.
What? There is nobody inside the car. You sure? We pulled him over because he was driving too fast, and now you say nobody's in the car. Damn, you're right, man. No one's in the car. There must be a freaking ghost right now, guys. Anyways, it's your boy Jet. This is Loco. Welcome back to another epic adventure, guys. We now inside the freaking heart, guys, filled with old fire trucks. We found there's actually many fire trucks inside this building, guys, inside this hangar. And problem is, the owner is actually living inside this hangar, guys, the door and the building next to the hangar, guys. But we can go through the doors, and then we are actually inside the house from the owner of this hangar, guys. So we're not going to do that. We're just here for the fire trucks. I'm with my pal Rodrigo right now, and yeah, look, it's actually the first two fire trucks you're going to see right now. It's actually very old, from the 50s. And anyways, smash the like button now. I know you love abandoned cars and trucks, guys. Well, this is actually the place to go and explore if you are one day in Belgium. You definitely need to check out by yourself. It's epic. All right, let's go into the video. Hangar itself, there's actually sort of, I don't know, side building here. It's a long way and dark. It's actually scary, guys, how dark this is. The owner, guys, is calling Costa very fast because he doesn't like that there's actually people in his hangar right now. He guess we are here to destroy the fire trucks, but we have cameras, so we have proof that we are here for taking pictures and recording this play right now for my YouTube channel, man. But check this out, guys. A freaking old Alfa Romeo. Looks sportive, and yeah, I actually like the car. If I could, I should buy a car like this. It's very nice looking, man. Check this, crazy. Check this out, baby. A freaky boat as well there. Two boats actually, and if I'm gonna have a random cup right now, guys, it's because my battery is almost dying. It's actually flickering right now, so it's a couple of seconds and then it will, yeah, my camera will be dying right now. Look, guys, very old fire trucks, man. Oh, there's actually a torch, dude. Actually, the crazy part is all doors from the fire trucks open, guys, so we can explore the inside the fire trucks as well. There's actually proof. Check this. This is freaking amazing. Look, another dodge there. Jesus Christ. I freaking love this place. This is actually on the way in. It's so weird how the freaking trucks changed by years by now. If you're gonna see the fire trucks right now, guys, it's actually very high tech. But back in the days, from the 50s, you see how where they made the Phaedrix. I mean, the design was actually very weird and huge. Just like this fan right now, it's actually very huge. If you're gonna see those trucks right now, guys, you'll see that they're actually a little bit smaller. Check this truck. They're filming me, that's the caravan. And that is actually for an owner now. But look how freaking old this is right now, guys. It's actually Bedford. I don't know from which year that is right now. Maybe we kind of find it out. This was actually an old fire truck from Bruges. Oh, it smells bad. I hope we're gonna find some evidence that there's actually here from which year this is. But I guess I don't see any evidence. Probably, guys, let me know in the comments below, what do you think? Maybe the 50s? Another old one, but those are actually newer right now. And that is one from the freaking airport. Some more Phaedrix, guys. Look, they built this freaking Phaedrix from 1951. So you can see it's a very old one right now. It's a six-cylinder diesel. Jesus. Let me know, guys, if you want to see more places like this, a freaking hangar or a building filled with old classic cars and trucks as well. I actually know there's a place in Germany that they actually place a compound filled with old abandoned tanks from World War II or one, I'm not for sure, guys. And those tanks are actually just standing there, and I will definitely visit that right now. I mean, this year, or maybe next year if I can. Yeah, there's actually a sort of someone from, a Romanian warrior, I guess. This is actually so sick. A medical truck here. It looks like an old SWAT van. And now we're gonna whisper a little bit, guys, because we are now getting close by the freaking door that actually goes to the owner of his house. But this truck looks from the 40s. That's my opinion, guys. Mask. Whoa. Dude, I don't trust it anymore. That's actually the car from the owner that informed me, guys. That white van. Guys, let me know if you saw that freaking door just closed by itself and out there. Dude.
There's actually doors that go to the house or owner.
Alright guys, now on the freaky roof from short building that I just found. I climbed the ladder right now from this fire truck, and now I'm here on this. So we have a better overview about this whole hangar, guys. And as I see the end of the video now, it was a nice exploration. Actually my first one that, yeah, I did, filled with abandoned fire trucks. Well, it's actually very, very nice. So guys, if you enjoy this, then just smash that like button. Let me know in the comments below if you want to see more sick places like this, but filled with abandoned cars, like I said previously in my video, guys. I will definitely search for some buildings, I mean, places with abandoned cars, trucks, you know. But here in Belgium are actually a lot of places with abandoned cars, especially cars, not always abandoned trucks. So this one is here now, yeah, a full hangar with abandoned trucks, baby. I'm a little bit dirty because I had to climb, but yeah, this was nice. Thanks for being part of this adventure, guys. It was a pleasure to take with me to this adventure. If you want to support my video, definitely smash that like button. It means a lot for me, the likes, and that means you enjoy my content. So that is actually thing that motivates me a lot. Also, let's write something in the comments below, guys. I will definitely answer all your comments. And if you're new and you enjoy this type of videos, guys, subscribe to my channel, put my notifications on so you'll see my upcoming videos as first. And also, if you want to support me than only liking this video, you can buy some of merch or donate something small to my PayPal. Every single bit helps me a lot, guys. It's all in the description, so make sure to check it out. And also, before I forget, if you can make a short clip, 20 seconds, telling about my channel, why they need to watch my channel, guys, and you will get featured at the beginning of my video, I will use that clip. And just see that as a huge shootout. And that's actually amazing. 20 seconds long. If you can send to my email address, it's in the description as well, or upload it on Mediafire and send me the download link and I will download it from Mediafire. So I just want to say you that, guys. And yeah, thanks for being part, and like always, have a nice day. It's your boy Jesse Dix, and I'm out. Peace.